dozed off. By then, the crowds had thinned, and I saw the officer standing on his own. I made my way over to him, and I introduced myself. I think I said something to the effect of, I apologize for staring so rudely early on, but it reminded me of someone I knew. Are you by chance related to a Rear Admiral active in September of 44? The officer seemed surprised. He said, well, yes, it was very likely, as he had decades of naval background in the family. I had to know. Does the name Rillingsworth-Travis mean anything to you? The officer looked shocked. It's my cousin, but he was in the infantry. Good Lord, were you in the army with him? I told him yes, that I was his commanding officer at the time. The time when he went missing on his raid. The officer told me that he had received, along with the rest of the family, the letter commending him for the many lives that he had saved. Apparently, after he had been taken prisoner, he escaped from the POW camp. On his way back, he got involved with one of the death camps. The officer then told me that he became a bit obsessed with what we call the Shoah. When he got back to London, he was put in charge of a portfolio-raising fund for disabled ex-servicemen that wanted to settle in Palestine. I told him that was incredible because I was one of the first who benefited from that fund. Yeah, look, I suspect we'll be seeing each other more often at these dues. Welcome to Israel. Parted ways now. That's that, then. Stokes would have relished the irony of it were he alive to learn it. He was killed about a month afterwards.